Good day, children. Sai Ram. Welcome to the class of English New Voices. Today we are going to continue with lesson number 7, China Silk, written by Sudha Murthy. In our previous class, we had already read a small part of this lesson. This lesson is about how the knowledge of making silk left China. Children, in today's class, we will be reading the next part of this lesson. But before that, let us understand the meanings of new words and use them to frame sentences. We are going to understand the meanings of those new words which we will be coming across in today's part of the lesson. So children, let us proceed. The first word is dawn. D-A-W-N, dawn. D-A-W-N, dawn. D-A-W-N, dawn. Dawn means the first appearance of light in the sky before sunrise. The first appearance of light in the sky before sunrise. Now let us use this word to frame sentence. We started our journey to Goa before dawn. We started our journey to Goa before dawn. The next word, surrounded. S-U-R-R-O-U-N-D-E-D, surrounded. S-U-R-R-O-U-N-D-E-D, surrounded. S-U-R-R-O-U-N-D-E-D, surrounded. Surrounded means encircled. The sentence, the robber was surrounded by policemen. The robber was surrounded by policemen. The next word, exchanged. E-X-C-H-A-N-G-E-D, exchanged. E-X-C-H-A-N-G-E-D, exchanged. E-X-C-H-A-N-G-E-D, exchanged. Exchanged means gave and received one thing in place of another. Gave and received one thing in place of another. The sentence, my mother exchanged the old pressure cooker for a new one. My mother exchanged the old pressure cooker for a new one. The next one, gossip. G-O-S-S-I-P, gossip. G-O-S-S-I-P, gossip. G-O-S-S-I-P, gossip. Gossip means casual conversation about other people. Casual conversation about other people. The sentence, it is a bad habit to engage in unwanted gossip. It is a bad habit to engage in unwanted gossip. The next one, grand. G-R-A-N-D, grand. G-R-A-N-D, grand. G-R-A-N-D, grand. Grand means large and impressive. The sentence, my uncle's wedding was celebrated in a grand way. My uncle's wedding was celebrated in a grand way. The next one, artifacts. A-R-T-E-F-A-C-T-S, artifacts. A-R-T-E-F-A-C-T-S, artifacts. A-R-T-E-F-A-C-T-S, artifacts. Artifacts means objects of historical and cultural importance. You can see artifacts in museum. If you go to the museum, you can see many artifacts. All those are objects of historical and cultural importance. Now let us see the sentence. Indian artifacts must be preserved. Indian artifacts must be preserved. The next one, elaborate. ELABORATE, elaborate. ELABORATE, elaborate. ELABORATE, elaborate. Elaborate means detailed and complex. The sentence, the dancers were wearing elaborate costumes. The dancers were wearing elaborate costumes. The next one, hired. H-I-R-E-D, hired. H-I-R-E-D, hired. H-I-R-E-D, hired. Hired means paid someone to do a particular job. Paid someone to do a particular job. The sentence, my mother hired a maid to do the household chores. My mother hired a maid to do the household chores. Okay. The next one, amuse. A-M-U-S-E, amuse. A-M-U-S-E, amuse. A-M-U-S-E, amuse. Amuse means entertain. The clown showed many tricks to amuse the audience. The clown showed many tricks to amuse the audience. Okay children, before we read the next part of this lesson, let us have a quick recap of what we had read in our previous class. In a tiny village in China, there lived a poor girl whose entire family was engaged in weaving business. One day, as she was working in the fields, the emperor who was passing by saw her. The emperor noticed the way she worked in the fields and also saw how her hands had become rough because of the hard work she did throughout the year. The emperor fell in love with this girl and he decided to marry her. The girl married the emperor and came to live with him in his palace. In spite of all the luxuries she had, she was not happy because she had spent her childhood in wide open spaces in her village, surrounded by greenery. And now she had to stay inside the palace. Now let us read further. Children, I will be reading this part of the lesson 3 times. 2 times I will read and you will listen carefully and understand. And the 3rd time I will read and you will read after me. She was used to working from dawn to night without a moment's rest. But now she had many servants to take care of her needs and did not know how to fill her time. Fill her time means how to pass her time. In the village, she had been surrounded by family and friends who exchanged news and gossip as they worked. But in the palace, it was quiet and no one spoke out of turn. The emperor noticed his wife was sad and tried his best to make her happy. He bought her grand clothes and jewels and artifacts. He threw elaborate parties and hired the best musicians of the land to amuse her. Yet she was sad. Children, I will read the 2nd time. She was used to working from dawn to night without a moment's rest. But now she had many servants to take care of her needs and did not know how to fill her time. In the village, she had been surrounded by family and friends who exchanged news and gossip as they worked. But in the palace, it was quiet and no one spoke out of turn. The emperor noticed his wife was sad and tried his best to make her happy. He bought her grand clothes and jewels and artifacts. He threw elaborate parties and hired the best musicians of the land to amuse her. Yet she was sad. Now children, the third time I will read and you will read after me. She was used to working from dawn to night without a moment's rest. But now she had many servants to take care of her needs and did not know how to fill her time. In the village, she had been surrounded by family and friends who exchanged news and gossip as they worked. But in the palace, it was quiet and no one spoke out of turn. The emperor noticed his wife was sad and tried his best to make her happy. He bought her grand clothes and jewels and artifacts. He threw elaborate parties and hired the best musicians of the land to amuse her. Yet she was sad. Children, I will explain this part in short. The empress had all the luxuries, but yet she was not happy because she had the habit of working before sunrise till night. Now she had many servants to look after her needs. She did not have any work to do, and so she was finding it difficult to pass her time. In the village, while working, she was surrounded by family and friends. They used to exchange whatever news they got. They used to chat with each other and spend time joyfully. But here in the palace, there was no one to talk to her. No one talked unless and until it was necessary. The emperor saw that his wife was unhappy. To make her happy, he brought her expensive clothes, jewels, artifacts. He organized grand parties, hired musicians to play fine music, but nothing worked. The empress was yet sad. Children, I hope this part is very clear to you. Now, I will be asking you a few questions based on the part which we read today. Who had the habit of working from dawn to night? Who had the habit of working from dawn to night? The empress had the habit of working from dawn to night. The empress had the habit of working from dawn to night. Why did the empress find it difficult to fill her time? Why did the empress find it difficult to fill her time? The empress found it difficult to fill her time because she had servants to look after her needs and she did not have anyone to talk to her to. The empress found it difficult to fill her time because she had servants to look after her needs and she did not have anyone to talk to her to. Okay, fill her time means to pass her time. Okay, next one. Who was she surrounded with in the village? Who was she surrounded with in the village? Yes, she was surrounded by family and friends. She was surrounded with family and friends in the village. She was surrounded with family and friends in the village. The next one. What did they do when they worked? What did they do when they worked? Children, it is gossip, not gossips. Okay, it is gossip, not gossips. What did they do when they worked? When they worked, they exchanged news and gossip. Next one. What did the emperor notice? What did the emperor notice? The emperor noticed that his wife was sad. The emperor noticed that his wife was sad or unhappy. The emperor noticed that his wife was unhappy in the palace. The emperor noticed that his wife was unhappy in the palace. What did the emperor do to make her happy? What did the emperor do to make her happy? The emperor bought grand clothes, artifacts, jewels, threw elaborate parties and hired best musicians to amuse the empress. The emperor bought grand clothes, artifacts, jewels, threw elaborate parties and hired best musicians to amuse the empress. Amuse means to entertain. Okay. Did the emperor succeed in amusing her? Did the emperor succeed in amusing her? No. The emperor did not succeed in amusing her. The emperor did not succeed in amusing her. So children, with this we come to the end of today's class. I hope what we had done today is clear to you. So in the next class, we will continue with the next part of this lesson. Till then, take care. Bye. Sairam.